How you doing? My name is Matthew Wright. I live in Richmond, Virginia, and I'm a spiritual teacher and a empathic, intuitive, and a spirit medium.
My name is Jeremy Elliott, and I'm also from Richmond, Virginia. I'm a spiritual teacher, a psychic medium, clairvoyant.
Yes. And what we do, if you look over our website here, we just try to help people and help spirits too, as well as physical people. A lot of them come through to us just asking for help and just reaching their friends, family, and stuff. They want to settle matters and let them know that they're all right. So, well, this is what we wanted to do for you, and so let's go with it.
All right. Well, we got Simmie coming through.
Yeah. I want to speak about it. He's been coming through to me since like the day after he died. He's been around me. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's always been around. You know, me and him have similar, well, it's mental wavelength almost. Mm-hmm. We think alike, you know? So, I know he feels comfortable around me because I constantly see him, you know? Him and the cat. So
yeah, white cat, fluffy white cat.
Mm-hmm. I'll let you go with it.
Yeah, Simmie is a very sensual dude. You know, very, very, he's a beautiful man, you know what I mean, with the white cat, you know, he hangs on to. Go ahead.
What was it said? Just describe him more, like, start with that.
Yeah, you know? He's wearing, like, a black and white striped shirt. This is how I see this. And just jeans kind of just spread out, you know. Very relaxed looking, feminine, you know, a bit.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
He enjoyed that, I believe, you know, the feminine way of life, you know, for a male.
Big on cooking, too.
Cooking, taking care of people, taking care of his boys and his, you know, anything like that. He was the helper, you know.
Yeah, he liked looking out for people, man. I've always seen that in you, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm the same way.
He smiles a lot, you know.
He's happy where he is, you know. Mm-hmm. It's almost like it was, I hate to say this, but it was almost like a relief for him in a way, you know. To leave his body,
yeah.
You know. I mean, like, I know that's hard to hear, you know. Oh, look, I know it is, but it's, that's how he feels.
Now he's satisfied and very, very relaxed. I can tell, sensual, like I said, he's very sensual, rubs himself a lot on his knees and stuff. He's very, you know, he wants to be sexy. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, like he likes that.
Nothing wrong with that. And it's easier to do. I mean, you're not tied to one physical body. You know, he can look more feminine when he wants to or more masculine, just by thought, you know, switching up, you know. And he does that. Sometimes see him as more feminine, sometimes more masculine.
Right.
Sometimes with the hat on, sometimes not.
Right,
you know.
Right, both ways.
And but look, brother, man, you know, I mean, you know me well by now. I know you, but you know this is for your people, man, so, you know, speak your mind, my brother, for real.
He just had it this kind of wave, like this. He's waving.
Waving.
Yeah. Might get a lot of words from him.
He's quiet. This is a real, he's always quiet, you know, so quiet.
But imagine me being Simmie going.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's like, I mean, that wave must mean something to
yeah.
You know? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Must be the way he waved or something.
Yeah. But,
he's, just seems very content and happy, you know.
Just wants y'all to know that.
Yeah, it's more important, you know, for his family to know that he's okay. You know, maybe in this world things got out of hand, but where he's at now is okay. You know, he's chilling.
No doubt about that. You know, I mean, I just can't, I mean, like, this is special to me for real because, like, I see him so much, you know. Like, I've gotten to know him pretty well, and I know, you know, me and him, but, you know, he's really just, I gotta say, he's happy. I mean, just please understand that in your heart. You know, no matter which way he died, you know, and all of that, how it happened, you know, man, he is happy.
Yeah,
you know,
he's way happy.
He's thrilled to be not in that physical body anymore.
Yeah.
You know, Like, I mean, I think that's why he died, maybe. You know, it's almost like sometimes people's spirits take control. And, you know, when you, instead of somehow, I know this is hard, it can be hard to hear, but sometimes the soul itself takes control. And then when somebody's deeply unhappy with living in the body, like, they get extracted. The universal will get you, get it out, you know?
Right.
You know, but it might happen in crazy ways sometimes, but even that has a purpose.
It's almost like the soul is urging to get out of the body somehow and manipulates what's around it to have it happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the people that killed him, you know, like, have things to learn from that, too. You know, like, that happened for a reason, you know? They had lessons to learn in life, as hard as it is to hear. And
right.
They had things to learn, mm-hmm. you know? And maybe that's why it happened. Like, I don't know, you know? But I see a purpose. There's always purpose behind every little thing, you know? Even the worst stuff.
But Simmie is okay, you know? Wanted to make that clear.
Very abundantly clear.
And he has a white cat.
The white cat probably might make sense to them, too.
Yeah.
That's a constant. I always see forever has... Forever has that cat.
The white cat.
Look like a Persian cat.
Yeah, yeah. Real fluffy and stuff.
Forever holding that cat, you know. Mm-hmm. Sometimes the cat will play with other animals. When I'm at my friend Christy's house, like, you know, like, her son is psychic and he sees spirits too. He's 8 years old. Like, he was saying one day, he's like, you know, this is a dog. Christy's dog had died a month and a half ago, but he's like, you know, Boo Boo's playing with that dude's cat. You know, the white cat.
Yeah.
You know, and this is two spirits. Animals don't die either, so nothing dies. Yeah. But you know, the dog and the cat are playing.
No bugs, spiders, worms, anything. Nothing dies. You know, trees.
Even an ant, a roach, even doesn't die.
No.
You know.
Keep coming back.
I mean, it's just. I mean, I hope you can find peace in your heart from this. This is all we try to do. You know, like, we do this to help people, you know. We never charge anybody a penny, you know. I mean, and we just do it to help, you know. Try to get people to recognize that.
Hopefully that was helpful.
I hope it is, you know, because, like, just know he's, you know, just keep that in your mind. Like,
he's one of the happiest people I've ever seen being on the other side as far as being more relaxed and just okay with everything. He's very relaxed.
The world's not looking down on him anymore.
No.
He doesn't feel like, you know, people judging him for being gay and the way he dressed and all that.
Right.
That's gone.
Cross-dressing, you know.
It just doesn't matter. He's just happy now. Like, no one, people don't judge people on the other side like that. That's strictly in this world, you know.
Yeah, this world is
very judgmental.
Got a lot of bite to it, yeah.
But that's basically, I guess, that. Well, look, you know, if you want to talk to us, we're here anytime, you know. I mean, don't feel hesitant about calling, you know.
Yeah, if you have more questions or anything you'd like, the concerns, you know, that you would want to run by us, then maybe we could have the answers for you. You can give me a call, 804-325-0995.
Okay. And I'm at 804-641-9082.
This is Jeremy and Matt. So,
call anytime. I mean, you know, I mean, or write. You see the Facebook page and on here and the email, just whatever you want to do. Don't hesitate. That's what we're here for. We're here to help. For good. All right.
All of our information should be below the screen.
Yeah. Yep. That's true.
All right.
That's true. All right.
Peace
be with you.
Peace.